Fascinating people, fascinating places. G'day, and welcome to the Dan Mainwaring Podcast.
Are you sitting comfortably? The following is an original story by Daniel Mainwaring, author of The Treacherous Exhibit. It's based on real events. The names have not been changed to protect the innocent. It's not Law and Order, after all. It's historical fiction. You can find this story and more in text or audio form at www.danielmainwaring.com. Click the link on the podcast homepage for more information.
Seashells. Treasure chests make the transportation of loot a simple process. No such containers are found at the beach. The legionnaires were using their helmets as makeshift baskets. The contents of these were poured into buckets otherwise used for gathering water, food, and spices. No one dared ask, "How will we transport our rations if the buckets are full of shells?" "This is a waste of time," moaned Lucius. "The shells are scarce enough, and the few I've found are broken." "I found a nice one," retorted Gaius, as he proudly displayed his pinkish clam shell. Lucius was unimpressed. "What do you propose to do with that treasure once you get back to Rome? You can't use it as currency, and it's inedible. This is not the bounty we signed up for." "My niece collects all kinds of pebbles," Gaius explained. "I am sure she will be pleased to add these colorful shells to her collection." Lucius shook his head. His companion, a 40-year-old veteran, was no doubt pleased to avoid battle. Collecting seashells was better than being slaughtered by Britons half his age. "I have heard the women have red hair and ample bosoms. That was the treasure I sought," Lucius said lustfully. "You're married," snapped Gaius sternly. "My wife is of no use if she's 1,000 miles away, you old fool. You're as mad as Caligula if you think Rome will celebrate his conquest of the sea." He stretched his hand out over the shoreline. "I mean, look at it. You can see the white cliffs on the other side. It's little more than a river. Conqueror of the sea? What a joke. We were supposed to be conquering Britain." His aging colleague had stopped listening. "Look at this," he exclaimed, "a starfish." "I've had enough of this nonsense," Lucius barked. He turned his helmet upside down and scattered the contents into the lapping waves. Hat back on head, he stormed off. "What on earth?" muttered Gaius, suddenly alone. Something glinting in the sun had caught his eye. He crouched down as quickly as his creaking knees would allow. "A gold ring," he whispered. Retrieving the item from the beach, he dusted specks of sand from it and inspected the inscription. He couldn't read, but he knew the emblem of Caligula. The ring was his. He must have dropped it when he was riding about doing his victory lap. "I had better return it," he thought out loud. But then a second idea crossed his mind. When the order had come to gather the shells, Caligula had said, "Those who search hardest will gain the greatest rewards." Perhaps he left this here as a prize for the most diligent searcher? In the distance, he saw the emperor, wildly performing ritualistic exaltations to the sun. Lucius was right. Caligula was insane. He tucked the ring into the pocket of his gown. A lunatic like that was hardly likely to miss a ring, even a golden one.
Well, stone the flaming crows. It's time for Dan to do the Harry. Watch out for the next podcast and follow Dan's activities at www.danielmainwaring.com.